the best vaccine is the one that's in your arm. Currently, we don't recommend, and our experts don't recommend wearing double masks yet. We have in the past mentioned that if you do have vulnerable family members at home, kunwari kayo yung nag-work, tapos sila yung nagsistay, di ba? So nag-advise naman tayo doon na in those cases or very limited yung space sa bahay, then masking is actually going to be an option even at home. There was a very good quote in America, no? The best vaccine is the one that's in your arm. Alam natin na the COVID infection, pag sinabing, mako-COVID ka, hindi siya actually the same, no? It can be mild or asymptomatic COVID. It can be moderate COVID. You will require a nasal cannula, no? So may oxygen support ka lang. And then the worst part is severe COVID, wherein you're all alone and no one can visit you, no? No one in your family can visit you. So, that said, it is going to be important for us to look at what can the vaccines protect us from. And the vaccines can protect us from, one, mild COVID, mild or asymptomatic COVID, second, from moderate or severe COVID, and third, from transmission. So, yung ngayon, dun sa three outcomes na yun, yung last one, yung it can help transmission or transmission blocking siya, hindi pa po maganda yung evidence doon. So wala tayong kasiguraduhan na if I'm vaccinated, hindi na ako makakahawa sa ibang tao. Wala, hindi pa clear yon. But for the first two, the data is pretty clear. No? So mild and asymptomatic COVID and moderate to severe. So sa moderate to severe COVID, all of the vaccines that are on the market are almost no perfect dito. Dun sa isa, dun sa mild and asymptomatic COVID, nagbabali yung number. Ito yung meron. 50%, may 60%, may 70%, may 90%. Pero dun sa isa, pretty consistent, no? Most of them are in the 90s, 100%. And para sa amin, no, sa healthcare practitioner, yun yung practical nating isipin. If you're afraid of mild to moderate COVID, it's like being afraid of normal flu, di ba? But what's the difference with COVID is you're actually afraid of the severe COVID, yung pwedeng ikamatay, yung ina-ICU na COVID. And if that's the value of the vaccines for us, then you actually don't need to choose because all of them are comparable in that outcome. Actually, we work with experts from the specialty societies, and so we continue to recommend the use of the vaccines, and particularly among pregnant and breastfeeding mothers who also happen to be healthcare workers. So the evidence is still benefits outweigh the risk for us. So I think for now, some do get hospitalized following the vaccines. More severe forms of nausea, headache, fever, no, na mas extended periods of time that require them to be hospitalized. But overall, the worst that has been reported is death. But the death has already been ruled out as not caused by the vaccine. So I think we also want to emphasize that when we talk about the reported AEFIs, even if it's not related to the vaccine, we still tally it. So far, we're around at 3% of the entire people who got the vaccines did experience AEFI. I think the evidence is clear. COVID-19 selectively, is really harsher for elderly and people with comorbids, diba? So your chances of dying from COVID is significantly higher for someone who is older and someone who has comorbidities. So for many of our young people who are supporting their elderly, diba? So young adults, sila na yung nag-support sa family nila. We know that COVID kills or makes it really very hard before you actually expire, no? So you incur a lot of cost bago ka talaga bawian ang buhay sa totoo lang. And that process, even with PhilHealth reimbursement, will still entail costs. I think that's one of the main reasons they could use to convince, no? Hindi to mabilisan, no? So it's going to be very costly. Second is, until now, we still don't know the long-term implications of having COVID-19. Parang in articles, scientific articles, some will say na, okay, you will get reinfected, it can get worse, etc. So the best way is really to not get infected at all. And if there's a possibility for that through the vaccines, then go ahead. So, I think the last 2 months, we were quite successful after Christmas and New Year, and we all, because of our collective effort, we were able to control, di ba? And siguro nakalabas naman yung mga tao ng konti. But we're at a critical juncture now, and we are asking everyone a little bit more patience. Let's maximize all our online tools, because interacting with other people will require us to remove our masks. Syempre, when we meet them, we usually eat together. And that's really something na droplet heavy, no? Kumakain, nag-uusap-usap. And that's something that we don't recommend. The recent spike, particularly in healthcare facilities, are actually driven by this behavior. Ito talaga na po point nila, kumakain together. So at every point in time, lalabas kayo ng bahay, just reassess, what risk am I putting myself? And kung hindi naman po, no, masyadong urgent, then we recommend na wag na lang muna. So the first reason why we're unable to vaccinate kids now is because there's no evidence. No, all of the clinical trials, they also had to prioritize. Alam naman natin, it's not the kids who's dying. So the target population were actually adults. So with that, we have no evidence that kids can receive the vaccine. So now, if we're talking about herd immunity, we said that some people within the community cannot receive it. Yung mga nagka-allergy, di ba? Severe allergy pala. Or the kids, for example. So if all the adults make sure that we are vaccinated, then in some ways, yes, we are protecting the kids because they're going to be the beneficiaries of herd immunity. Issued a lot of statements already about this. We are not endorsing any such device because of lack of evidence, no? So kami naman, basta may ebidensya, we recommend it. But we are also not stopping people from buying it if they want to, if it makes them feel safe.